Hi guys, right, last lesson. Okay, so we're going to work on the silver medal music. Okay, as usual, make sure we have a quiet place to do it if possible. All right. Your wider opportunity booklet. Okay, you'll need page 14, but you will also need, to just double check, page 11. All right, so we need page 11 as well. Okay, all right, guys. So all of those you need, all right? Not just all of those scales, but you need page 11 and page 15. So, moving on, all right? The whole series of lessons that I've put together for the last 9 lessons anyway, and this is lesson number 10 now, have been building towards making sure that you guys can not only play, but you understand some of the trickier, I suppose, aspects of music, but also you understand what it takes just to get to that next level. Remember, we talked about warm-ups and we've talked about scales a little bit, and we've talked about all sorts of different things, yeah, about breathing, about dynamics, about different musical markings and things like that. And all of these things I'd like you to try and keep hold of, right, really tight hold of in your memory, so you can then pick them up again as you carry on playing, hopefully, and you can pick them up again and use them and think, oh yeah, actually Mr. Holt taught me that. Yeah, brilliant, perfect. All right, remember that bit. All right, and if I can make that one little bit of difference to you guys in your musical journey, perfect. I've done the job that I wanted to do. All right, okay. So last time we did a lesson on one hand, one heart. Okay, that's just checking. All right, so we did a lesson on one hand, one heart. Okay, but we did the whole thing. We explained about the first and the second time bars, about the repeats, about your dynamics, about your ties, tying notes together so they became longer, so the notes themselves became longer, about your E flat 2 and 3, your B flat 1, about pushing your air to the top of the mouthpiece just to try and make sure that you got that note, about breathing properly and breathing where those commas are and everything else like that. However, what we didn't do, we didn't put it all together. All right, that's what I want to do first. All right, so primarily, let's have a quick warm-up. Remember those lip slurs that we tried, all right, a couple of lessons ago? Let's do those again, all right? They're really handy, but there's something different each time, all right? So. I'm going to try your middle valve now. First valve. And if you can, first and second. All right, so it's just something a little bit different. Let's try it the opposite way around now. So starting on the higher note and going down. All right, so G down to C first. Just a little bit of something, just to try and make it a little bit different for you, okay? Remember, there's always the option of doing the long notes with the starting off quiet and then making it loud and then bringing it back down again. Just remember the crescendo and then the diminuendo. Do it on a low note, though. Don't do it on anything high. And when you do warm up, don't go too high too soon, all right? Because if you do go too high too soon, your lip will just go, hang on a minute, what are you doing? And then it'll just go, shut up, shop. It won't work. All right, guys, so we need to get it lots and lots of tingling, almost like you've got pins and needles in your lips, all right? But it's a pleasant tingling feeling, all right? Okay, right, so one hand, one heart, all right? What do you think? Should we do it all the way through? All the way through, right? Top to bottom, all right? Remembering first time bar, second time bar, flats, tied notes, breathing, all right? Spacing things out, okay? I'll play it first for you, and then you can have a go at it. Right, I want to just push all the way through, all right? Just so we can practice this, so you can then rewind me if you need to and everything else like that. Go back to the previous lessons if you want to and everything else, all right? So but I'm going to play it all the way through once, all right? That's all I'm going to do, and then we're going to get you to play all the way through it once, and then we're going to move on to the other stuff that we need to get done for your silver medal. All right, guys? Perfect. Let's have a go. After three. One, Okay, right. So, it's quite a long one, isn't it, guys? Like I said before. However, the important thing is we take it in little chunks, little sections, and that's why we broke it up into those sections in the previous lessons. Right, so, shall we have a go? Yeah? Let's just get straight on with it, yeah? No messing around, right? So, after three, get yourselves warmed up, all happy with that. Pause me if you need to warm up a little bit more. Okay, and then we'll get straight on with it. Ready? Okay, right. One hand, one heart. Top to bottom with the repeat and the first and second time bars. Good luck, guys. I know you can do it. All right. One, two, three. I'll help you all the way. Okay. Big breath. And breathe now. Louder, first time bar, breathe, E flat, two and three, boom, hold it, breathe, hold it, breathe, beginning, boom. Big breath again. Big breath coming up. Get louder. Second time. Breath. Big breath. Good, well done. Right, okay. Hard that one, guys. Hard, hard, hard. But if you can do that, the rest of it's going to be a piece of cake. Honestly, it's going to be dead easy for you. All right? So, right, what I want you to do now, take yourselves off, have a little break, have a drink of water, have a drink, something like that. Don't have juice if you can help it, because that will go down your instrument, all right, and then make it a bit sticky. All right, make your valve sticky. Just water if you can, please, guys, okay? And when you've had that, pause me by all means. Come back, and then we'll get on to a couple of the little bits about what is involved with your silver medal. Okay, guys? Right. So, that's me back in now. Okay, so we're going to do now scales. All right? So your scales will be involved with, we'll need C major and A minor. Now, we've gone through C major before, and I'm pretty certain we went through A minor as well. All right, guys? So, C major and A minor are both really quite relatively straightforward, but we need to remember them. All right, we need to remember them. Why? Because that's what music is made up of, scales. Okay, start off with C major. All right, C major, we start on a low C, and all we do is play one octave. Remember, octave, octopus, eight notes, okay? We play one octave going up and one octave coming down. So it's called ascending and descending. So ascending going up, descending coming down. So listen. Okay, that's it. That's C major, okay? Now then, remember we talked about C major and it goes C, D, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. And then we just do it in exactly the opposite order. B, A, G, F, E, D, C. All right, that's it. Just that, exactly that order. All right, it's written in your book. All right, on page 11. Right at the top there. Can you see it? It says C major scale and arpeggio. We'll get into the arpeggio in a minute, all right? But all it is that and then back down again, okay? That's your C major scale. That's all I want you to do, all right? So have a go at that now then, please. After four. One, two, three, four. Okay, happy with that? If not, go back, rewind me, all right, and try again. That's fine. Keep going. You need to remember that, though, all right? It's not a case of, oh, I can look at the music and do it when you're in your exam, all right? You need to remember it, okay, guys? So don't worry about it. Just try and remember it, all right? Now then, the arpeggio should be quite straightforward, this one, I think, all right? The arpeggio, we play the first note, we play the third note, we play the fifth note, and we play the eighth or the first note in the upper octave again. All right, and all that is this. Okay, ready? Okay, C, E, G, C. G, E, C. That's all it is, okay? Happy with that? Perfect. Let's try those two together now. All right, so we're going to do the C major scale and then the C major arpeggio. All right, let's try that. Ready? One, two, three, four. And the arpeggio. Crikey, I've got a bit of a gurgle in the bottom of my trumpet, haven't I? Let's wash that in a minute. Right, okay, that's all it is. Okay, guys? All it is, all right? So, what I want to do now is we're going to go on to a minor scale, all right? So, major, happy. Minor, oh, sad. I'm a bit sad because I'm a minor scale. Not a major scale, I'm a minor scale, all right? That's all it is, yeah? So, we want to make it sound sad. How do we do that? Well, what we're going to do is we're going to play A minor. Now, I went over this in the scale section that we did. In I think it was lesson six, this is lesson 10, so four lessons ago, all right? We went over A minor. A minor is the relative minor to C major. And when I say relative, it's like, it's not like a brother or a sister, it's more like a cousin, I think is probably an easier way to put it, all right? It has the same key signature, so it has no sharps or flats in the key signature, but it does sound different. All right. Whereas C major doesn't have any sharps or flats either, but that sounds quite happy and quite jolly, whereas A minor sounds a little bit sad, a little bit spooky, okay? So A minor, what we must remember in an A minor, in a minor harmonic scale, and this is the only one we're going to be doing for now, but the A minor harmonic scale, all right, is the seventh note, which is a G. Remember, count up, A, B, C, D, E, F. G there, that G is going to be raised by a semitone. So it's not a G natural, as it would be in the key signature. It's going to go up to a G sharp. All right, and it hurts me every time, but I've got to tell you. The sharp looks like a hashtag symbol. Oh, Every time it gets me, I can't say it. All right? However, I'll say it for you guys to make sure that you understand what we're doing. All right? Sharp came around a long time before hashtag. Ages. All right? Ages, like years. Even before I was born. I know it's hard to believe, however. All right? But what I want you to do now, guys, is remember sharp, G sharp, 2 and 3. Okay? Listen to this. This is a G sharp. All right? That's all we're going to play is a G sharp. All right? Have a go at that now. Just play me a G sharp now. At that pitch. After 4. 2, 3, 4. Good. Well, 2 and 3. That's all it is. Right, okay. Now then, when we're going up A minor scale, right, we're going to go A, B, C, D, E, F, G sharp! A, G sharp! F, E, D, C, B, A. That's it. Yeah. Was the G sharp obvious enough? Not sure. Let's try it, okay? Listen to me first. Watch your music. Your A minor is there, all right? Okay, can you see it? Got it? A minor harmonic scale and arpeggio. All right? The arpeggio, again, takes exactly the same format as the C major arpeggio, all right? And I say same format, it means we play the first, the third, the fifth, and the first an octave or the eighth note higher, okay? Yeah, happy? Let's do that. This is A minor harmonic scale. Okay. Did that sound a bit spooky? Sounds a bit creepy sometimes, maybe, just a little bit sad. All right, so any of those, that's fine. All right, but remember that G sharp. Right, play it along with me now. We'll play it at the same speed. I'll count you 4 beats in and we'll do it exactly the same speed this time. Okay, guys? Try it again, nice and gentle, all right? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, that's it. Keep going over C major and A minor scales, all right? Every time you get your instrument out of its case, every time. I do all my scales, pretty much every time I get my instrument out, all right, pretty much. I go through majors, minors, all sorts of stuff, yeah, all right. It takes me about 20 minutes, I think, half an hour sometimes, all right. But that's just because I like to keep on top of them, plus I've got to keep on top of them so that you guys can learn from me as well, all right, okay. So, and I find different ways to learn them as well, so like alternative ways, if you like. So if there's an easier way to try and remember it, then I'll try and find that for you. All right. So next one is the arpeggio. And this is the last one, the arpeggio for A minor. This is part of your silver medal. All right. So the arpeggio for A minor is first note, third note, fifth note, and the octave up the eighth note or the first note again. All right. So it's A, C, E, A. Just think, the A minor arpeggio is ace. A, C, E. Okay? Watch this, watch this. First two vowels. Oh, a bit of a gurgle in there again. What did you think to that? What did you notice about it more than anything? That's the important thing. What did you notice about it? All right? Anything? Yes. It only uses the first two vowels. And then we have to lift it up for the second note. And then the first two vowels get pressed down again. And we leave them pressed down again. Until we're coming back down. And then that's C. And then back down to the A. So listen, it goes A, C, E, A, E, C, A. Okay? That was amazing singing. I've got Simon Cowell at the door at the moment. But he might come back. I don't know. We'll see. Something to do with being a brilliant singer. Okay? Let's try it again, guys. Okay, a little bit of water in there still, all right, but I'll empty that out in a minute. All right, so we're doing this and really remembering the scales, all right? Now then, sometimes what I do, I don't know if I've done it on this video or not actually, but I'm sure you'll be able to check. Sometimes I go, and I shut my eyes. because I then envisage and think of the scales like this, yeah, like C major and A minor, and I think of them in my head, and I sort of try and picture the music in my head as I'm playing them. Sometimes that works, sometimes it doesn't. Yeah, it works for different people. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. But try it, all right? But try something that fits and works for you guys, not just the way that I do it, all right? But try something that fits and works for you guys. That's really, really important, all right? Because not everybody learns in the same way, all right? The way that I teach might be different and difficult for you guys, but then actually for others, it may be perfect, all right? And somebody else might teach it in a different way, and then you go, oh, of course, I get that. All right, so let's just try some different ways. Keep experimenting with your music. That's the important thing, because that then keeps your interest going, yeah? All right, and keep pushing yourself, all right? Okay, so guys, there is other stuff as well within your silver medal. There are the oral, so listening, perception, and clapping back a rhythm, singing back certain notes, and something else we call sight reading, all right? Sight reading, it's something pretty straightforward, but it's something that we just need to touch on now. And sight reading basically is playing a piece of music that you've not seen before and playing it the way that it's supposed to sound, or as close to that as you can get. All right. So by all means, pick a random tune out of the book, and it will be at silver medal level. Your sight reading will be something along the lines of maybe, there we go, you see, Lightly Row down there. We might ask you to play the first line or the second line, or we might ask you to play a tricky tune maybe, or something like that. All right? But it's about testing your knowledge of your musical knowledge of crotchets, minims, sometimes semibreves or whole notes. All right, when we talked about the whole note being a semibreve, half note being a minim, quarter note being a crotchet. Yeah, and stuff like that. That's sort of more the American way of learning things, all right? But it's still a way, if you find that easier, a way of you learning the length of notes. But also, then we test your pitch of the notes, that you know which ones you're playing. And you also know which vowels we press down and everything else like that. So there's lots and lots and lots of different things that we find that we can do there, all right? And we just test to make sure that you have got that good baseline musical knowledge that you need in order to progress, to go forward a little bit, all right, and continue your musical journey. And then after that, like I said, there's the oral perception part, which is just the listening, like we said, clapping a rhythm back, and that's pretty much it. And then a viva voce, which is called, which is basically about just general musical knowledge. So remember when we talked about those commas in One Hand, One Heart, about what they mean, about what a crescendo looks like, about what a diminuendo looks like, what do those ties mean, how long do they last, how long do those notes last, what does a dot after a note do, yeah? That's half the value of the note it's attached to. That's what a dot does, okay? Those are the sorts of answers we're looking for, all right? So just general things like that that just give you and will completely help you support your musical knowledge, not just now, but going forward as well, okay? Progressing and carrying on, okay? Right, guys, these lessons, this is my last one, okay, for now. I've really enjoyed doing them, all right? Like, really, really enjoyed doing them. I hope they're out on YouTube or on the Blackpool Music Service website or anywhere else for a long, long time to come. I sincerely, sincerely, sincerely hope they help some of you, all of you, or indeed even just one person. All right. What I'm concerned about is that it helps you enjoy music as much as I have, because I've really, really, really enjoyed my music so far. Yeah, I am 40 years into playing. All right. I've been playing for 40 years and I don't want to stop ever. I want to get my trumpet out and play every day. All right. Why? Because I want to be better. I want to enjoy playing and I love playing music. I want you to feel that passion as well, guys. OK, so. Enough of me talking. Enjoy the rest of your musical journeys, all right? If there's anything else that you need, by all means, contact Blackpool Music Service, all right? I'll still be with them, I have no doubt, for a number of years, I hope, all right? And I'll still be there to help, and if you want lessons, give us a shout. Okay, guys? Right, look after yourselves. I hope you've enjoyed it, all right? And please keep going. keep trying, never give up, all right? Show that resilience. All right, guys, well done. See you later. Bye-bye.